So first of all, my name is Yash Goti and I'm security analyst and some firm. Okay, I'm semi-developer. It means I'm not developing everything, but I'm developing small scripts to automation the recon. Okay, am I audible? Hello.
Yes, we can hear you. Go ahead.
Okay. So this is the agenda for today. What is recon? What is recon-lit? Okay, this is tool by made by me. And staging of recon. What are the stage of recon? And after then question and answer. Okay, recon is an important step to exploring the target and grab the public information. Okay, so how public information is used to further pen testing. So this is called recon in my terms. Okay, now what is recon-lit? Recon-lit is a updated version of sublister. How many of you heard about sublister? Sorry. Okay, just a sec. I don't know what happened. Why this is not working? Okay. So how many of you heard a sublister kind of thing? Sublister is a tool who crawls many search engines and page the domain or subdomains of that target. Okay, so I made a one tool. Just a second. Okay. Here is my tool. Here is my tool, which is recon-lit. Okay, it's kind of modification by me, and base code is from Abdulillah, who is a owner of this sublister. And what it does, it search your domain. Now here we have people. Okay. So he start searching people in every search engines and get the subdomains from that thing. So I have total 2, 3, 2, 6 subdomains from the various search engines. Now here is what my tool does. First thing, sublister is listed the subdomains. Okay, so we have 2, 3, 2, 6 subdomains. So I can't फिजिबल लाइक आई मतलब कि मैं जाके हर देख नहीं सकता हूँ कि 2, 3, 2, 6 सबडोमेन्स लाइव है अलाइव है या वर्किंग कर रहा है कि नहीं कर रहा है. सो मैं क्या करता हूँ लाइक एवरी सबडोमेन हर सबडोमेन को जाके रिक्वेस्ट करता हूँ इफ इट इज रिस्पॉन्डिंग विथ स्टेटस कोड देन देयर इज अ स्टेटस कोड. ओके, देयर इज अ स्टेटस कोड एंड इफ सबडोमेन गेट रिडायरेक्शन ऑन एनीथिंग then it will show redirection. Okay, after then okay, where is the port scanning? Okay, so it get the servers if it is available, server banner, after then the IP of the domain subdomain, and open ports. There is basic ports which is like 10 or 20 ports. It will scan and show you the service, which service are running on that port. So this is the thing which my tool recon-lit is doing. Okay, this is my tool is doing. After then I select people.com as my what say, just a moment, where is the presentation? Okay, so this is my tool recon-lit. Find subdomains from various search engines and archives, and find alive subdomain from them and get the redirection from them, and basic port scanning from them. Okay, so let's move to stage of recon. So what is recon? First stage is select your target. Now we are at we select target as people.com because it is an open bug bounty platform. So enumeration of subdomains. So now I want multiple subdomains from people.com. so there are many of tools are available for subdomain enumeration. After then, enumeration technology, or which technology are running run by that subdomain or domain, and how it can be useful to us. For example, if PHP is running, so PHP is kind of vulnerable thing in technology, so we can exploit that PHP. So that's why it is useful that enumerating technology from that subdomain. After then, enumerate hidden directories or directories for that subdomain which you are going to target. After then, finding endpoints. Like in JavaScript files, there are many of endpoints available in a JS file. So found that endpoints and targeting that endpoints and using hidden parameters, and then exploit the thing. Okay. After then, finding hidden parameters, finding open ports, and start testing. Okay. So now we have target as a start dot wildcard dot paypal dot com. Okay. So I need to find multiple subdomains of paypal.com, or paypal.com has a third or fourth layer subdomain. Now what is third and fourth layer subdomain? For example, paypal.com has a www.paypal.com. Now it has also a www.demo.paypal.com. Okay. So it is the second layer. Now what is third layer? It xyz.paypal.com. So this is how subdomain is working. Okay. Find more sources that you can find subdomains. Okay. So these are tools which are very efficient in subdomain enumeration. First of all, I love sublister. Second thing, recon-lit, which made by me. Okay. And third is aquaton. Aquaton is a quite cool thing. MS is amazing tool to find subdomains. It is very large amount of search engines, and it is very, very good to find subdomains. Okay. And fifth tool is find domains. It is also available in Git. And there are some of website, and cert.sh is literally quite cool thing to find subdomain. What it does, it gather all the information of certificates which are registered on the time of purchasing subdomains. After then, find subdomains.com, DNS dumpster, search dns.netcraft, and all. So this is the status. So what my tool does is subdomain. It has 2326 subdomains. So I get the screenshot. So okay. Okay, I'm not forgetting. So done. Later on, I will go on through. So Python 3. Recon-lit, which is my script, hyphen d for domain, and paypal.com. Now I selected demo.paypal. Why I selected demo.paypal? Because it is in developing stage, or it is in like sandbox staging. So there are many things that developer can left over there, and they are not taking actions on that thing. So I think demo.paypal is a good thing to demonstrate. Okay. After then, just a sec. Okay. Now what? I have 2326 subdomains. So I'm not literally able to go and check every subdomain is running, or what kind of thing it is running. So what I do is eyewitness. Eyewitness is the tool which go to your domain and take the screenshot and give you the screenshot information, and you can find and select the target from that thing. Okay, just a moment. Okay, after then identify technology where used by target. Okay, so here we have demo.paypal.com. So later on I will show you that how technologies are useful for for recon. After then, finding endpoints, that is very useful. Okay. So, okay, identify technology like WebL. These are extensions which used by, for example, I am going demo.paypal.com. Okay, so, okay, so here is a WebLizer, which are very useful thing for analytics. Demo.paypal use Google Analytics for a front end JavaScript libraries for jQuery, and it also shows the version. So if version is vulnerable, then you can exploit the site or website or web application to exploit the thing. Payment processing is used by PayPal, obviously, and which UI front end bootstrap is used by this thing. sorry. Okay. So which technologies are used by demo.paypal.com? So these are the useful things for us. After then, let it go on. And okay, identify technology. Build with is extension which is very useful, and in detail it give you the technology details. After then, what's run is also a good thing. Okay. So now enumeration of directories. There are many tools to enumerate the directories, hidden directories, or some things like this. So I personally use four things. This is Derby. Derbuster is a GUI version of Derby. And after then, directories, dir search. It is directory search and GoBuster. GoBuster is also used for Sabarmati enumeration tool. So here is a thing. Okay, let me show you. Can I move this thing? Okay. So here is a Derby. So I start Derby on demo.paypal.com, and these are the things what I got is components, CSS, downloads, go home, and every size is literally small. So I cannot think that this is a useful thing, but here is a download. Okay, so download has a very large size, like 2 MB or something. So it is quite interesting. And after then, I also start the directory search .py. Okay, this one, and I also got 2 MB of download file. So these are the tools. Very useful directory enumeration, and after directory, okay, where are the thing goes? Okay. So these are the results for directory search. After then, finding endpoints and hidden parameters. Finding endpoints, like I earlier told you that link finder is a tool where you have to give a URL of JS file. And it can find all the endpoints from the JS file and listed below. So for example, a JS file has version v1/api/get users endpoints, and these endpoints use get parameter, for example, user ID. So now what you have to do is go to that URL, for example, demo.paypal.com/version1/api/?get users is equal to give the user ID, and it lists all the users which are available on their platform or their website. So this is quite useful to find endpoints of every website or every subdomain. In earlier, Kathan Patel was said that SSRF, you have to find SSRF endpoint also in JS file. So this is quite interesting thing. After that, parameter. Oh, okay. So parameter is a kind of tool which enumerate or which can find hidden parameter for that URL. For example, we have demo.paypal.com. Okay, now it has a hidden parameter is for example user. So you have to just start parameter on that, and it has a word list. So what it does, it try to every parameter on that particular just a moment. Okay, so what it does is go and find that parameter with a value of any random value, and you can find that parameter and exploit it in further. Okay. After then, finding on open ports. So basic port scanning is done by my tool, so you can have a kind of idea that yes, this is a vulnerable thing via network, or I can exploit these things. So these are some kind of like useful tools for finding open ports, like nmap, masscan. Masscan is a large amount of it can give you a large amount of exploits comparison to nmap. After then, auto NSE. What it does? It does take output from nmap and run every script on particular ports. So auto NS NS is a best thing to run scripts on NNAP. After then Sodan, yes, someone told me that you forgot Sodan. I'm not forgetting Sodan. Sodan.io is very useful. If I can do, here is my Sodan. I go and view. Okay. So here is the two ports are open, 80 and 443. So I can see the public encryption keys and all from Sodan. So it is a quite useful thing also in recon. Where is my presentation? Okay. These are tool to find open ports and exploiting it in further. After then, these are the aggressive scanning, aggressive command to like using open ports. What it does is PN is a 4 ping online. -y3 is 4 verbose in third level. -p- is 4 every port from 1265535 ports. -sv. -sv for version detection or version detection on that point, that port. After then we have -st for TCP port scanning on 1265535. After then we have -su. It is for use for a UDP scan. After then we have -o for voice detection, -a to aggressive voice detection. After then we have -t4 for aggressive detection on a particular that point. After then we have demo.paypal.com. So here you can put also IP or many IPs over there, and you can find open ports. After then --script is equal to wildcard. Wildcard is used for every scripts is running on that particular host or domain, and find every, if there is a CSRF possible, then it gives you that there is a CSRF attack is potential there, and you have to exploit in further. After then we have okay, Sodan dot key is also useful for finding open ports directly from Sodan. And then here is what I got. Okay, so let me show you how I did. So paypal.com, here we have 2326 subdomains. I am checking every subdomains, like this is a subdomains, it don't have any open ports or filter ports. Let me scroll down a little bit. Okay, these are not responding subdomains, but they are literally working on networking or in web browser, but there is no response from my tool. So that is showing that it is not responding. Okay, just a moment. So I'm finding which tool, which subdomains are useful to exploit here, and here is our target demo.paypal.com. Okay, so subdomain is like a kind of pattern of thing. For example, if you find that PayPal corporation or internal subdomains you want to find, then there is a PayPal corp corp.com. So it is a pattern, so in which PayPal corporation is using that subdomain. It is not for publicly, or it is not for users. It is for developers or PayPal's employees. So you can find star.paypalcorp.com, and you can find many of PayPal subdomains over there. After then, we have redirection on demo.paypal.com. It means it has their own website. After then, server is also nginx. Here is the IP for nmap or anything, and these are the open ports. Okay, in FTP it is a like kind of filter or open ports over there. So there is a thing. Now subdomain has large amount of resources that you can find multiple subdomains. For example, cert.sh. cert.sh is a very kind of cool thing that I Here is a star.paypal.com. So what it does, it give me the every subdomain which end with the paypal.com. Okay, just a second. Okay, so these are the things. Like here we have star.qa.paypal.com. It means it has a more subdomains for qa.paypal.com. So what I do, I go and start doing this and searching for star.this and this. So we have more subdomains and subdomains of subdomains. It means two layers, three layers subdomains are there, and you can find on it is a like if is this domain is registered with PayPal and it has certificate for it has certificate, then it is listed on that. Okay. Here is a search.sh, a large amount of subdomain information. After then we have MRs. MRs is a great tool to find subdomains for like target or everything. Like it has a command like enum. Enum is mean enumeration. What we have to enumeration hyphen d paypal.com. And after then I want SR symbol. It means where these IP are coming from. For example, cert.sh, Google, Yahoo. Where it is coming from? After then, I have I want IP of that domain or subdomain. So I can run this, and it took some time. So we are going further. Okay. So what we what we go through is first get the target. So we have target star.paypal.com. So these are the staging of recon, like how you can go deeper and deeper on recon. So first, if first of all you have to select the target. Here we have a wildcard.paypal.com. After then take a screenshot of every subdomain. Eyewitness is a tool where you can use and screenshot every subdomain. And later on you can find that yes, there is a admin panel. I can do testing on the admin panel of paypal.com. So yes, there is a interesting tool. After then I can found demo.paypal. interesting, as I told earlier, the demo.paypal is an on developing stage or an sandbox for PayPal, and developer left many things over there, and he's not even he's not putting permission on anything, any resources. So it is a very interesting thing. So I started find all the directories which is available. As I told earlier, directory and derby, dir search and derby are useful for find directories. After then, boom, I what found open directories name download which has a 2 MB size. So let me show you which what is a 2 MB does. demo.paypal.com/download. Okay. Okay. So here is a thing. Check out with PayPal. So it give you the logic or source code for checkouting from PayPal. Like PayPal has an own shopping website. So you can purchase thing from PayPal, and the checkout logic is here. So now what I do? Go to my downloads and I extract this zip file. So here is a thing, web content. We have web content like address.cancel, matlab bahut sari cheeze yahan se mil sakti hai. Okay, so here is a thing that I got for a source code disclosure. Here is the internal IP. Internal IP disclosed in some of the HTML files. After then I have SRC. SRC has a config file, and config file is config property. I'm not going to open it because it has a credentials for developers and all. So that is the thing why I'm not opening it. After then we have package, like in JavaScript file. We have source code of JavaScript that runs on server side, and how it performs and all things. So here is Okay, by the way, it is a $10,000 bounty, but I got a duplicate. So, okay. Who is here? So here is a source code for checkout and all. So this is how you can do recon in deep query. This is a, okay. MS is giving us a result. So MS querying this much subdomains, oh, sorry, search engines, website to find every possible subdomains for paypal.com. So it also shows you the where is come from DNS resolvers. Yes. So it gives you the IP and also one is for HTTP or one is for HTTPS. After then search.sh that where this subdomain come from. Buffer over and it gives you a large amount of subdomains. It gives it takes 70 requests per second and average request. Okay, it done yet is 20% and we have that much subdomains. Now what okay, here it completes 28.30% and we have lots of subdomains to target and export the things. After then took any subdomains and find here in directories, technologies, endpoints and start doing deeper and deeper for recon. I personally recommend Nahum's video, who is very very legend and at recon. After then we have Jason Headaches from Buck Crowd, which is also a good at like recon and things. So these are the things from my side. But you are found really amazing thing. Okay, just a moment. If you have any queries, please ask me. I'm like literally here. Jamin bhai, hello.
Yeah, yes, I can hear.
Yeah, okay. So is there any? Okay, just a moment. Is there anything that anyone can ask or want to know about recon?
So. Sure. So we are open for questions now. You can drop in your questions in chat. Yash will love to answer them.
And okay, sorry. Remarkable job. We are surprised that it was a duplicate. Okay, so, I know. Okay, can we get IPs in different TXT files? Okay, from my tools, not it is not possible to get all IPs in different, but I will working on that thing that you can list all other subdomains and IP on different files. So yes, I'm going to do that thing also. He just saw it in using cert.sh. Okay, recon tool are open sources. Yes, recon tool are totally open sources. There are many tools. I can share you one link which has all the tools for finding or like tools tool listed. So you can go with that. Okay, let me share you this thing. Web recon and here is a thing. Copy. Okay. So here is, okay, I didn't copy it. Okay, just a moment. I will share you a link later on. You can find amazing tools for recon over there. Okay. How you find subdomains or subdomain? Okay,
you can drop in the chat after the session. Yes.
Okay. How to find subdomain of subdomains? Okay. So here is a cert.sh. Okay. Now you want to find subdomains of subdomains. For example, we have here paypalcorp.com. Now I'm going to search paypal.com. On paypalcorp.com and I got the result from PayPal. Okay, after then go and start IP25.25. So these percentage are used for wildcard as a wildcard, and you can go deeper and deeper. For example, we have two layers, now we have into three layers. If there are, see, console.api.devs, es, and paypal.co. So this is how you can go through a subdomain of subdomains. Just a moment. Yes, I can make it better in further version. Okay. You can pass the same list which you got from the toolbag to tool for getting subdomains. Subdomain check cyber mentor video on the YouTube third level domain. Okay, so there is a there is a video on YouTube from Nahamsik which gives you the detail. Like layering subdomains from subdomains, after then subdomains of subdomains. So yes, you can do this thing. Okay, cert.sh is like Google for subdomain finding. Only thing which impact here is insert query. Okay, cert.sh is not like Google. Okay, cert.sh is collecting all the subdomains which are registered and have a certificate. So this tool is getting subdomains from that thing, and Google is giving you subdomains from them archives or the crawler which are run by Google or a thing. So now both things are different. Yeah, the query is same, but both things are different. And if you want the output in JSON file or anything, so you can do and output is equal to JSON. So you get all the output in JSON file, and after then you can extract from there. But you don't have to, you don't need to do this, because MS is already there to doing all the things by itself, because it gives you the search.sh outputs over there, and also give you the IP and things. So MS is a base tool to find a large amount of targets for any organization you are targeting on. Okay. Just a moment, let me see. Okay, seems you are going here. Webex, Webex URLs are very useful in recon, because if some developer or some like employee forgot something to remove from the website, and Webex URLs archive that thing and store in somewhere, so you can find Webex URLs and go that thing and find some useful information on further. For example, if you have find credentials from Webex URLs, and you can use that web URL credentials on current website, and it is working, then yes, Webex URL are very useful. Use find domain if tool most use find domain it finds. Okay, Kathan, I agree that find domains is find most subdomains, but I'm go with MS, because MS took very large amount of subdomains. So yeah,
okay, thank you, Yash. If you guys have more question, you can connect on Twitter for Yash.
Okay,
and ask him directly in private chat. Okay. Because we have one more session. So thank you so much, Yash, for the amazing recon.
Thank you, give me the opportunity for that.
Yeah, really appreciate you taking time and taking the session over here. Thanks a lot.
Thanks.